Hi students, friends, good afternoon to all. I welcome you all in this Fluid Mechanics virtual lab. So in today's virtual lab session, we are going to see the venturi meter, that is calibration of venturi meter, how to do the calibration of a venturi meter, right? So before proceeding ahead, see the simulation of this venturi meter. Let us have a quick view overview on the theory of this venturi meter, okay, and then we will see the actual, we will solve some self evaluation questions, and then we will see the simulation of this venturi meter. Before that, let me know from your side whether am I audible to all. Maza awaaz yetoy ka tikade sir, is there any difficulty? Okay, am I audible? What is venturi meter? Venturi meter, I think you might have remember, you might remember this, you have studied already. Venturi meter is nothing but it is a flow measuring devices which works on the principle of Bernoulli's theorem or Bernoulli's equation. How it works? By creating the pressure difference between two sections, we measure the that pressure difference, and then from by measuring that pressure difference, we find the value of H, and that value of H we put in the equation, and we will get that discharge, actual discharge we will get there. So to know the, to get the actual discharge, we have to multiply the theoretical discharge by coefficient of discharge, right? Q actual is equal to, it is CD into Q theoretical, right? This is the formula to get the actual discharge, right? We are interested in actual discharge because actually how much discharge is taking place, that is our point of concern. So we must know the this value of CD, and finding this constant, the value of CD is nothing but it is calibration of venturi meter, right? How we find this value of CD in our practical, in our lab? CD is calculated, or it is obtained by formula Q actual upon Q theoretical, right? How this Q theoretical is obtained and how this Q actual is obtained? If you remember, can anyone tell me how we obtain the actual discharge in the practical? Yes, anyone? No one remain, remember? There we use, we take the help of the measuring tank. We have the measuring tank, and with the help of that measuring tank, what we do? We store some amount of water for a certain time. We measure, we collect the volume of water. We measure that volume divided by time. You will get the actual discharge. And theoretical discharge we find by using the formula Q theoretical is equal to A1 A2 into under root of 2GH divided by in bracket 1 A1 square minus A2 square. So this is the formula to find out the theoretical discharge. Theoretical discharge here, A1 is nothing but it is the area at the throat, then that area at the converging or inlet section. A2 is the area at the throat, right? And this H is nothing but it is the manometric head difference, right? So component of venturi meter, let us see some theory part about this. Component of venturi meter, it has the three components: converging cone, diverging cone, and throat section. Cylindrical and trans section, converging conical section, then throat and last one here, diverging section. These are the components. So what are the dimensions here? Converging conical section ji dimensions kya rahega nikas the angle include angle kitna asto ha 21 degree to plus or minus 2 degree converging cone. This angle is greater as compared to the diverging cone angle, conical section. Okay, this angle is just as compared to the diverging. If you see here in the diverging section, the angle is 5 degree to 7 degree Celsius, 7 degree, not Celsius. Okay, this is 5 to 7 degree. It is 21 degree to 20 plus or minus 2 degree. Okay. or we can say round up roughly 15 degree to 20 degree plus or minus, it is given written here. 15 ते 20 डिग्रीच्या दरम्यान साधारण अँगल त्या ठिकाणी असतो. थ्रोट सेक्शन, द थ्रोट डायमीटर इज युजली बिटवीन हाफ टू द 1/4 ऑफ द इनलेट डायमीटर. इनलेट डायमीटर जी असते त्याच्या हाफ डायमीटर किंवा 1/4 डायमीटर तेवढी त्याची थ्रोटची डायमीटर असते. टाइप्स ऑफ व्हेंचरमीटर, स्टँडर्ड लॉंग फॉर्म ऑफ क्लासिक व्हेंचरमीटर, ओके. Then modified short form where the outlet cone is shortened. Then eccentric form of to handle the mixed phase. This is eccentric type of the venturimeter, you can see. Okay, as a center jo hai to same nahi hai. Okay, center ha. There is eccentricity here. And rectangular venturimeter is there. These are the various types of venturimeter. This is the typical diagram which is of the venturimeter, which is used for the pipe flow, circular pipe flow. This is converging part, throat and divergent section. And this is the application of Bernoulli's theorem to derive the equation. And at last we get this equation, V2 is equal to A1 A2, and for the discharge A1 A2 upon under root of A1 square minus A2 square upon under root 2 GH, right? This equation. So here, let us now, after reading this theory part, self-evaluation questions we will see here. The angle of diverging or converging section has to be kept minimum to, these are the option, give less space for the liquid flow, avoid fluid separating from the boundary, both the above, none of the above. What is your guess or answer from your side? I want to know which option is the correct one.
C.
Option C or B? Yes. First one is, I think, not correct. B, give less space for the fluid flow. So it don't have any relevance. Avoid fluid separation from the boundary. This is the correct answer here. Let us check answer is correct one. The angle of diverging or converging section. Yeah, next question. Ooh. The value of coefficient of discharge of orifice meter is much smaller than the venture meter. Is it true or false? Yes. Is it true or false? कशाचा कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ डिस्चार्ज जास्त असतो? ओरिफिस मीटरचा का वेंचर मीटरचा? The value of coefficient of discharge of orifice meter is much smaller than the venture meter. So this is the true one. वेंचर मीटरचा कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ डिस्चार्ज हा कमी असतो. दिस इज आवर राइट आंसर. नेक्स्ट वन, द व्हेलॉसिटी प्रोफाइल नियर द वेना कॉन्ट्रॅक्टर विल बी. वेना कॉन्ट्रॅक्टर कुठे ऑब्झर्व केला आपण? इन द ओरिफिस, द टँक मधून पाणी या ठिकाणी ओरिफिस बाहेर पडतो, या ठिकाणी काय होतं? सो दिस पोर्शन हॅविंग स्मॉल स्मॉलेस्ट क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया, दिस इज कॉल्ड द वेना कॉन्ट्रॅक्टर. आणि या ठिकाणी the streams are, that all streams lines are parallel to each other, right? And here the velocity profile near the vena contracta will be parabolic, not nearly rectangle, hyperbola not zero. So nearly rectangle will be the answer because they are acting in a straight line. So let us see the answer for this. Which one we have selected? Nearly rectangle. We have not selected the option. Nearly rectangle is the correct option. Next one, what is the normal range of converging cone of the cone of angle of vena venturimeter? Kiti angle asto? Just now we have seen 21 plus or minus 2 dillo the, so it is nearly, you can say 15 to 20 degree. It is not 7 to 15, 2 to 5 not, it is also not. Converging cone cha angle ha? This is the correct answer. So here our four options were correct, but we have not selected one. That's why it is showing the score here, 3, right? Now, let us perform the practical here. Yes, where is the step one? Pipe of the required diameter is selected and other are kept in closed position. Okay. एक पाइप आपल्याला सिलेक्ट करायचा आहे. लेट अस से दिस 20, सिलेक्ट द डायमीटर, विल से 20 डायमीटर. ओके, हा सगळ्यात खालचा पाईप आपण सिलेक्ट केला आहे, त्याची लेंथ आहे 3 मीटर. देन वी विल मूव अहेड. नेक्स्ट स्टेप, स्टेप 2, द मेन इनलेट वाल्व इज ओपन टू अलाउ वॉटर टू फ्लो थ्रू द सिलेक्टेड डायमीटर पाईप. ओपन द पाईप वॉल अँड चेंज द नॉट ऑफ मॅनोमीटर from isolated position to the air vent position to remove air inside the pipe. Okay, now here we have to move the valve. A 20 diameter is a pipe hota, tyada apan move kela ani ata ya tikani ha valve apan open kela. Ata air vent aplya ya tikani kay karayche, open karayche. Theek hai, so that air bubble will get removed. So now water is coming here and you might see here the readings. Left limb madhe reading alle 50.8 cm and right limb madhe alle 31 cm reading. Okay, head loss, here we have to calculate the head loss. Do the calculation. Take your calculator and do the calculations. H equal to, we have to calculate 50.8 minus 31 bracket complete is equal to 249.48. Let me let me check the answer. It is showing the exactly, it is 249.477. आपलं उत्तर आलं तर 249.48 चुकीच आहे म्हटलं. मग त्यांनी मोर ऍक्युरेट रिझल्ट वी हॅव टेकन हियर. ओके, नो प्रॉब्लेम. लेट अस से हियर नेक्स्ट. नेक्स्ट, नाउ द वॉटर इज मूव्हिंग हियर फॉर द वेंचर मीटर, राईट? What we have to do here, water is now allowed to flow through the selected venture meter and this flow is made constant. At this flow rate, the difference in the pressure between the inlet and throat is measured, right? Next, now here we have to close this valve for the measurement of actual discharge. The time required by the water to fill the 5 cm height is 25 seconds. So actual discharge you will get here from this, and these are the observation diameter. D1 was 2 cm, that is diameter of the inlet section. D2 is the diameter of the throat section, 1.36, and here areas are 4 and 1.8. Area of the collecting tank is given, rise in water level 5 cm, then time taken 13.3 seconds, head loss it has come to 49.48 cm, acceleration due to gravity 981 cm, and here we have to calculate the actual discharge, right? Actual discharge is nothing but it is cross section area of the tank multiplied by the height divided by the time. What is the cross section area of the tank? It is 6750 into rise in the water level is 5 cm divided by time taken is 13.3 seconds, and here I got 2537.59. Whereas you have to do the calculation simultaneously with me to check your answers. It is saying it is wrong one. सेंटीमीटर क्यूब पर सेकेंड। हाउ इट हैज कम? वी हैव द कलेक्टिंग टैंक 6750 इनटू 5 डिवाइडेड बाय 13.3 सेकेंड्स। आई लेट इट बी। देन क्यू थियोरेटिकल, हियर वी हैव टू यूज दिस फॉर्मूला ए1 ए2 अंडर रूट ऑफ 2 जी एच डिवाइडेड बाय ए1 स्क्वायर माइनस ए2 स्क्वायर अंडर रूट, राइट? सो व्हाट इज द ए1 ए2? इट इज 4 इनटू, what is a2? It is 1.8496. a1 a2 into under root of 2gh2 into 9.81, not 9.81, 981, that we have to take because all the dimensions are in centimeter. H value, head loss, it is 249.48 bracket complete divided by, again in square bracket, here divided by square bracket under root of a1 square minus a2 square. A1 is nothing but it is 4 square, that is 16 minus a2 square, that is 1.8496 square bracket complete. And we got here the actual theoretical discharge as 1459.427. okay, let us check it. Again, it is showing, it is expecting more accurate answers, but we have also given the correct answer here. Now, CD, we have to calculate. CD is nothing but it is the actual discharge to the theoretical discharge, 1350 divided by 1459.4273. And here we got the value of CD as a 0.9250. Okay, check it. राउंड अप केलेला आहे, द व्हॅल्यू इज 0.93. ओके, अँड दिस वे वी हॅव डन, वी हॅव फाउंड द सी डी फॉर द फर्स्ट ट्रायल. नाव लेट अस क्लोज द वॉल, सेकंड ट्रायल फॉर द सेम पाईप वी आर डूइंग हियर. Open the vent, close the vents, start the pump. This is the readings, left ring, right reading, it has been given 12.6 now again into in bracket 46.4 minus 36 bracket complete is equal to 131.04. Are you doing the calculation simultaneously? Correct. So water is to go moving through the venturimeter and it is coming down. I will say it next here. Close the tank. This is the discharge measuring tank. And here the time you have seen here, it is elapsed here 34 seconds. And to rise the water by 5 centimeter, the same again calculations we have to repeat for the actual discharge, that is the area of collecting tank 6750 into 5 divided by time it has come 14.5 seconds, and its value is coming 23, its value is coming 2327.586. Check it. So how it is taking this value, different values? I don't know. Collecting tank area might be different. Theoretical discharge here, A1, A2. I think it is there. Previous problem we have. Yes, A1, A2 into under root of 2G. A1 square minus A2 square. Yes, under root of A1, A2. And what is the value of H here? H has come here 131.04 is equal to 1010. It has come actual theoretical literature has come 1057.70. Okay, or we can round up it here as a 7-1. I will check it. It is showing the, yeah, exactly this is the answer. So we will divide it 992.65 divided by 1057.709. That's come 0.93. 0.9384. Around a figure, it has given 0.94. So previous cell, kiti alda? Anyone remember? So let us take one more trial here for the same pump, right? Trial 3. Open this valve. Open the knobs. Air vents. Next, rotate. Water is come here. Readings will come here, and we will write down this once again. The values here: 12.6 into in bracket 48.6 minus 32 bracket complete is equal to 209.16. Okay. Let me check it correct. Next, close. Reading 26 seconds. Just come. Actual discharge area of collecting tank 6750 into rise in water level 5 divided by 14.1 second. It's coming 2393.61. And so area took little this table, jo area to kiss any calculation with this is a very upper leg. That's why the blue three to kiss and A1 A2, then area is 4 into, I think already we have done calculation here. Let me check it, it is not there. 4 into 1.8496 is the area A2, then H is 209.16, it is the head loss into under the top A1A2 under the top 2GH5, right? It has gone wrong. 1 minute, A1A2 into in bracket square root 2 into 981 into 209.16 bracket complete divided by square root bracket. What is A1? It is 4 square. It is directly you can write here 16 minus 1.8496 square bracket complete is equal to, it has coming 1336.299. ते सूत्र घेतलं पण आता जरा चुकीचं म्हटलं यार अजून 1298.08 डिवाइडेड बाय 1336.299 इज इक्वल टू 0.97 0.971399. ओके लेट मी चेक इट अगेन, इट शोइंग 0.97 राउंड फिगर इट हैज टेकन 0.97. सो this way we have again why it is, how much trials it is asking to take. One more trial we will take. Twelve point 6 into bracket 53 minus 27 bracket complete is equal to 370.27.6. Okay, next. Next, close the wall. measure the actual discharge. Time has come 23 seconds. And do the calculation here. Put something, show the wrong answer, then correct answer. And here, let us find out now. Actual CD 1467.39 divided by 1672.386 is equal to 0.877, 0.877 has come. 0.88 it has to come. Okay. Now here, characteristics curve is going to generate actual discharge versus head. And this is the characteristics curve. It has generated from, it is becoming bigger in size. Give actual versus head. This is the characteristics for the engine. Okay. And in this way, we have to perform the practical. CD upon the article and cut it. Apply part CD appearances of the actual player. We have obtained the CDs. They can find out the average CD by adding the four readings and then dividing it by four. These are the assignment questions. Venture meters are used for the flow measurement. How? Why the divergent cone is longer than the convergent cone in venture meter? Okay. Why CD value is high in venture meter than vertical meter? Okay. References. These are the various references they have used for creating this simulator. Okay. Have everyone understood this practical venture meter? Is there any doubt in this? Okay, if you don't have any kind of problems about the venture meter practical, then we will see the next practical, that is friction in pipe. Okay, how to determine the coefficient of friction in the pipe. Okay, major head loss that you have studied. So let us see your theory about this. See, these are the different types of losses, minor losses they have shown here, pipe fittings. Head loss due to bend, then head loss due to sudden contraction, head loss due to sudden enlargement, right? Smooth pipe, then rough pipe, because of that, the major head loss, it is going to occur, this roughness is going to affect that major losses. This is the Darcy-Weisbach equation, HF is equal to FL square upon 2GD. That we have studied, and this is the, what I can say, Moody's chart, through with the help of which we can design the pipe network or different types of pipes, right? On the x-axis there is a Reynolds number, on the y-axis there is a friction coefficient on the left side here. So let us move directly toward the simulation. Okay. Simulator. Objective: we determine the friction in the pipe. Okay. Apparatus: pipe having different diameter connected to differential manometer, collecting tank, stopwatch, and scale. Let us start. Which pipe we have to select first? You can select any one pipe. I will select here 50 mm pipe first. Length 3 meter. Next. All pipes are closed, just we have to open only one pipe. I have opened this pipe now. Then I will select next. Then start the flow inside the. Now the flow is flowing only through the only one pipe, that is 50 mm diameter pipe. Now here, I will open this knob. I will open here also this knob. Air vents. Then next. Now water is coming through the pipe here. Next. Here we would like to measure the head loss in this pipe through this 3 meter pipe. So it is obtained by using this differentiability manometer, 12.6 multiplied by 10. It has come 126. Next, next. Close this valve so that we will get the discharge. Trial one. Time has come 18 centimeter to rise the water by 10 centimeter. The actual discharge will be equal to the collecting tank. It is 3500 into rising water level is 10 divided by the time taken is 18 seconds. So 1944. 1944.44 is the actual discharge. Okay, that is the correct one. Velocity, the actual upon here we have to determine the velocity. What is the formula here? Q actual divided by N D square upon 4. If you take this Q actual here only, discharge equation we know. What is the equation of discharge? Here I will write down. Q is equal to area into velocity, right? What is the area of pipe? It is pi by 4 into D square into velocity. So velocity will be equal to discharge Q divided by this value. All will come here in the denominator. 4 will come here, pi D square like this. Okay. So it is like this. So we'll put all these values here in this equation. Discharge into 4 divided by pi. Where is the pi? Pi into d square. What is the diameter of the pipe? It is 50 mm. 50 pi d square. It is 50 square. That I have to do bracket complete is equal to 0.99. Means we can write here 1 meter per second. Yeah, 0.99 means it is 99.07 centimeter. Analytical factor 2zd upon v square into h by l. What is 2g981d 50 into h 126 divided by v square 99.07 square into or divided by L, that is L, that is 50, not 50, it is 3 meter, means 30 centimeter. It has come 41.97. Correct. So once again, second trial. Find out the head loss. It is 151.2. Close the valve. It will measure the time. Next, do the calculation for actual discharge. Do the calculation for velocity. Do the calculation for factor. you will get another. Next one. Open. Close the vent. Start. Next. Readings. Next. Close. Next. Trial 3 is complete. So in this way, we have found this average analytical factor here, f is equal to, okay, and this practical is over here. Simulation, how it has to be done, that I have explained to you. You can practice at home also by clicking on this website. I will share this link in chat box. I have shared you the link. You can do the practice of this simulation at home also, right? So we have covered two practicals in today's virtual lab session. The first one is the venture meter, calibration of venture meter, and second one is the friction in the pipe. Okay. And in previous practical session, we have completed one practical, that is verification of Bernoulli's theorem. In this way, three practicals are over till now. Time is about to finish. I will take your attendance, then you can leave the session. Thank you for patience this morning.